Welcome to the underground, where the love is free and the music's playing too loud. Every night you'll come around, you won't wanna leave till the moonlight starts to fade out. No, you've been hot since.
Hello, hello, hello. How is everybody doing? Guess that y'all, what's up? I decided to do this little face full on camera view. I'm looking at myself and not the camera, so I'm sorry. We're gonna do a little video, and I decided to do it like this because this is me transitioning to trying to get in front of the camera here. Let me throw my hair back. I mean, it's not the first time y'all see me. Most of you guys have seen me in the camera when I'm doing a live, possibly. But that's not what's happening here today. Today we're doing this bone pretty, the gel nail polish. This is the magic gel remover. So we're gonna switch this around. We're gonna get to the front of this camera, and we're gonna see what's what with this magic gel remover. I'm gonna catch y'all on the other side of this camera. All right, y'all, we're back. That was really scary for you guys, wasn't it? That's okay. Y'all will only have nightmares for a couple of nights, and then it's over. You will forget my face. You will forget you ever saw me. You will pretend like we never met. I figured, you know, like, I have been talking about it. I've talked about it before, I should say, with some of the ladies, and how I feel like at some point it is a little nice, I guess. Not necessarily that it's important, but it definitely does help when you start stepping out in front of the camera to have that rapport, if you will, with your people, with my fam, with my nail community. So that way we can definitely, you know, I guess make it more personal. It's the best way that I can put it or word it. Anyhow, we're going to be getting into this Born Pretty. This is going to be the Magic Gel Remover. I wanted to try something with this, and I don't know if anybody's tried it yet, because I have not really had an opportunity to kind of see everybody's take on this or how they've used it. We've definitely seen it being used with a gel polish. But I wanted to try a little experiment just to see what would happen. Now, just to go over a couple of things. Of course, this is Born Pretty. This is the Magic Gel Remover. And the ingredients are plainly posted. I'm going to try this. We're going to try this. Water, magnesium aspartate. Guanosyl solum diatomate and sodium hydroxide. And I probably said one or two of those wrong, but it's all good. This does have a 3-year expiration date from the time of, I guess, production. But once opened, you can see right here, a lot of times when you see these, let me kind of zoom in. When you see these little logos, they all mean something different. And I know that I have looked these up and I can't remember what every single one of them are. But this one refers to, once the package has been opened, it has a 12-month shelf life, or a 12-month life. I guess that's the best way to word it. You know, it's going to last, you know, fairly decent at 12 months. And sometimes products can go longer than what the shelf life, or, you know, whatever you want to call it, from the time of, oh, no, I don't want to call it shelf life. That's like a full 3 years. From the time that it's opened, like how long it lasts. But these, I believe, are either recycled materials or are recyclable, cruelty free. This is definitely showing you how you can recycle this particular product. And then, of course, on the side here, you have how to apply. This is for gel polish. So this box is for gel polish, but this particular item is a gel remover. So in this case, You wouldn't necessarily follow these exact instructions. If you've dealt with polish removers or even like acrylic removers, you know that the top coat is everything. Everything, everything. It holds it in, it holds it down. And in order for you to have a smooth removal, even if that's like, what's up with this here? Even if I mean, from gel polish to acrylic, if you want to have like a really good removal or a smooth removal, even if it's like a soak off, it is absolutely paramount, mandatory. It is key that you remove the top coat or the top shine, so that way that you can get into the elements and break them down, and they can break down easier for removal. So this is what I want to do with this magic gel remover. I want to try something, like a little experiment, if you will. What I have here are two different products. This is actually, I was going to do something else, and then I thought, you know what, let me just skip on that. So this one on the bottom is one brand of polish that is a little more on the higher end. This one on the top here is Born Pretty polish. And let me tell you something. I just want to really touch on something. Just because something isn't high end as far as like the price tag or how much you pay for it, does not mean that it's not a good product. That is something that I really just want to touch on, because I think a lot of times we associate like quality with price, and that's not always true. So I just want to throw that out there. Anyhow, and then this is the second polish I'm going to be trying to remove. This one is also a Born Pretty. None of these have top coats. Of course, they just have the nice little shine. But I wanted to do plain, and I wanted to do glitter to see how they're removed. This is both one coat for all three of these colors. I also want to try to see how it works on these swatch sticks, and I'll show you what these are in a minute. So let me go ahead and get to these first, and then we'll work on these two over here, because I'm really interested in seeing how these play out. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm gonna just do the application. Oh my god, my little. Let's go ahead and apply this onto the nail. So I'm gonna go ahead and do this, apply this on here. I've got the fan on and it's blowing my hair everywhere. I feel like I'm in a convertible with the top down, baby. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and leave this on here for a couple minutes. There we go. All right, yeah. Let's go ahead and close this up. So I'm gonna leave this on here. I wanna show you really quickly before we move on to the next swatch sticks, what's happening here with this swatch stick here. Now this is the first swatch stick that I did. Of course, like I told you, at the bottom we have like a higher end polish, and then the top we have Born Pretty. Oh, I'm so sorry, y'all. I done smacked y'all around. Turn the light on so y'all can see a little bit better and see what is happening here. Definitely want to make sure that when you're working with this magic gel remover that you are gloved up. That is a must. Glove up. No glove, no love. That's just it. That's just period, okay? So I don't have my, I mean, I don't have it. I'm not gonna be using my e-file. Remember, when you're working with files, the lower the number, the coarser the grit, the higher the number, the smoother or softer the grit, I guess is the best way to put it. So if it's rougher, it's a lower number. If it's smoother, it's a higher number. So this is actually smoother than this backside here. You can even see the difference. This is gonna be the 80 and this is gonna be the 100. So I'm gonna go ahead and work on the removal. And you can literally, I don't know if y'all are seeing this, let me get in real close here. I mean, I probably could just peel it off with my fingers. Like I literally could. And you know what, I didn't even think about coming in with some alcohol and just wiping this sucker off. But I mean, so yeah, you definitely could have. And then the little stubborn parts that don't want to come off can definitely be filed off. Now this is the, like I said, the bottom one is a polish a brand that's a little more higher end. And the one that was on top is Born Pretty, which is the same brand as the Magic Gel Remover. So it definitely works well with its own. And you've really got to make sure that you're gloved up. And you do not want this gel remover touching your skin. I wouldn't. I'm just saying. This is just, I'm just throwing that out there to the universe. Y'all want to pick it up and put it in your pocket? You go ahead and do that. If you want to leave it on the ground, go ahead and leave it on the ground. But I'm just throwing it out there, y'all. Anyhow, so this is what became of the gel polish using the Magic Gel Eraser and a file. Okay? And again, make sure that you have gloves on when you're using the Magic Gel Eraser. Remover. Sorry, I keep wanting to call it eraser. Magic Gel Remover. It might erase if you don't. You better watch out. Glove up, please. Please glove up. And it isn't even just with this. I mean, you really, when you're messing with any chemicals or any products, I don't care if it's for hair, skin, nails. I just got a hold. Look at that. I would definitely glove up. We're going to use the same Magic Gel Remover, but I want to try it on something different. I want to try it on a dip powder and an acrylic. We've tried it with the gel polish, a higher end, than a Born Pretty polish, a cream and glitter, both. We talked about gloving up because it's extremely important, as you can see. These gel removers can be a little harsher, so you just got to be careful, that's all. I'm not saying it's... whether it's dangerous or not or whatever, that's stuff that you really, everybody themselves really has to look into whenever you're dealing with a gel polish remover. You know, make sure that you do your research and see which ones are better for you, which ones are for what, depending on what you want to do. And, you know, just be wise and smart about the decisions you make in life. Why not? So what we're going to do now is I wanted to try the gel... Magic Gel Remover, the Born Pretty Magic Gel Remover with a dip powder and an acrylic powder. Both of these, the top coat has been taken off to prevent the innocent. Names have been changed. No, I'm just kidding. The top coat's taken off to make it easier. Like I spoke about that earlier. So what I want to do now is I want to try the Magic Gel Remover. We're going to go with the dip powder first. So I'm going to go ahead and place it on the dip powder. I really am so curious to see, because I have used a gel remover in the past. Actually, once I'm applying this, it's starting to remove some of the color. I don't know if you can see that or not. I wiped it off a little bit, but it is removing some of the red. So let me go ahead and let me get this ready. I'm gonna do the same thing I did the last time, kind of lay it out on top of a alcohol soaked lint free wipe, and then I'm gonna go on to the acrylic. Now that was dip powder, this is acrylic. Okay, we're gonna see how this works. We've applied it to the dip powder, and now I'm applying it to the acrylic and see how long it takes. We'll see how long it takes. As y'all saw earlier, it started immediately removing the gel polish. So that was pretty cool. So on this one, this is, like I said, this is the dip powder. This is the one I did first. You can see how it's starting to eat away at it. So I'm gonna go ahead and give this a little wipe just to see if anything's came off. Yeah, and it is actually removing the dip powder. So I'm going to go in with my file now. Yeah, you can really feel. I mean, I can immediately feel it coming and lifting off. Like, immediately. So what you would do is, this, like I said, it's an experiment. We can see that it is actually removing the dip. So once I've done that, I went in with my first layer I let it rest on there for a little bit. Yeah, this color's coming off. I let it rest for a little bit and then went in with the file to start working the layers off. I went ahead and did another layer on the dip, and I'm gonna, let that sit. Now I wanna see how it works with the acrylic. This is what I was really excited about. I wanted to see. I'm gonna just go in with a lint-free wipe, a little bit of alcohol. I'm sure you can use acetone too. I'm sure that'll work. And the same thing, this is working the same way as the dip powder. You can feel it. Yeah, that's 100. You can feel it when you're doing the removal process. You can actually feel like the layers coming off from the acrylic. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and stop here. I'm gonna give my acrylic a once over one more time, just so y'all can see with the second attempt, like how much I can remove from this acrylic. It's literally peeling off. And this, again, like I said, is acrylic. So I'm gonna go with my 80. 80, yeah, it's just, it's coming off. If you're going to be using the Born Pretty Magic Gel Remover to take off acrylic or dip powder, the only thing I would suggest is to go ahead and use your e-file and break down, you know, as much as you can, especially even if it's just you're doing that first layer for that top coat, that's got to come off. We had no problem removing the glitter polish, the higher end gel polish, and the Born Pretty gel polish creams. No problem removing those. We tried it with this dip and the acrylic, and you guys saw how that worked. So it definitely will remove the dip, and it definitely will remove the acrylic. It just takes more time. All right, so that was it. Y'all saw how it worked with everything. I'm gonna go ahead and clean up this mess. I would definitely tell you again, over and over, I cannot stress enough. When you're dealing with the Born Pretty Magic Gel Remover, and not just Born Pretty, I want to stress that, not just Born Pretty, but any gel polish remover or product period of any kind, like doesn't have to even be a gel polish remover, it could just be gel polish, it could be monomer, like, you know, whatever. Whenever you're working with any type of product at all, like, you really want to make sure that you're protecting your skin, you're protecting your hands. You know, I've had some really bad experiences when I wasn't taking it seriously, and I worked in a hair salon, and I most definitely damaged the skin on my hands, and it was permanent. So now I'm dealing with this look that I have on my hands. It's not going nowhere. It ain't going nowhere, buddy. That's going to be it. Thank you guys so much. Like I said, don't forget when you're working with this product or any product at all, not to forget to put gloves on, wear gloves. So thank you guys so much. I appreciate the time that y'all have given me with this. Thank you so much, Born Pretty, for sending this over. I really do appreciate it. It's awesome, and I love that it works with the gel polish and with dip and acrylic. So, having said that, I'm going to let y'all go for now. I've held your hostage long enough, and I'm going to catch you guys on the next one. Goodbye, and adios. Get these nail products out of my face.